Hello and welcome to this tutorial on VRAY 6 for 3ds Max, and we are going to explore what are the best render settings for an exterior scene. In this video, I will show you how to achieve a realistic and fast rendering using some simple tweaks in the render setup window. I already have a scene here, and in this video I will only talk about render settings, as I made so many videos on how to set up lights, camera, 3D models and texturing. Before getting into the video, please give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. Also, don't forget to turn on the notification bell so you never miss any of our future uploads. Don't worry, I upload very rarely, so the notification thing won't bother you much. Thank you for watching and supporting the channel. So let's start the video. The first thing we need to do is to select V-Ray as our renderer. To do that, go to the render setup window and choose production rendering mode as the target. Then for renderer, choose V-Ray, save as defaults, and then choose your preferred image resolution here. For this video, I'm choosing 1080 into 1920 is the HD resolution. The next step is to adjust the image sampler settings. The image sampler is responsible for anti-aliasing and image filtering, which affect the quality and speed of the rendering. V-Ray offers two types of image samplers, progressive and bucket. For this tutorial, we will use the bucket image sampler, which divides the image into small regions and renders them one by one. While progressive rendering renders the entire image in passes and refines it over time, bucket rendering is faster and more memory efficient for final renders, especially when using distributed rendering or render elements. Progressive rendering is useful for previews and look development, as it allows you to see an image and adjust the settings as needed. Progressive rendering also works well with denoiser, which can reduce the noise level in the image. However, the choice of rendering method may depend on your scene complexity, render settings, hardware configuration of your computer, and personal preference. You may want to experiment with both methods and compare the results and performances. And for this tutorial, I'm choosing the bucket image sampler. The bucket image sampler has two main parameters that controls the quality and speed of the rendering: maximum subdivs and noise threshold. The maximum subdivs parameter sets the maximum number of samples per pixel that V-Ray will use to reduce noise. The higher this value, the better the quality, but also the longer the render time. The noise threshold parameter sets the acceptable amount of noise in the image. The lower the value, the less noise, but also longer the render time. Here you can see two different images of different max subdivs, and you can see the differences in quality when zoomed in. The image where I use maximum subdivs 100 looks way much better when zoomed in than the image where I used max subdivs 6. Again, here are two different images, on with noise threshold of 0.1 and other is 0.001. As we said before, the higher the noise threshold, the faster the render and the quality will not be good, and the lower the noise threshold is, the quality, the noise level of the image will be very good, and it will also take very long time. Clearly you can see the later image doesn't have almost any noise, but this image took a very long time to render. So finding a balance depending your processor power is the key for a good render. For this tutorial, we will use a max subdivs value of 48 and a noise threshold value of 0.005. These values are good compromise between the quality and speed for most scenes. You can experiment with different values to find the best balance for your scene. The next step is to adjust the GI settings. GI stands for global illumination, which simulates how light bounces around in the scene and creates realistic lighting effects. V-Ray offers several GI engines that can be used as primary or secondary bounces. For this tutorial, we will use brute force as our primary engine and light cache as our secondary engine. The brute force engine calculates GI by tracing rays from each pixel in all directions until they hit a light source or exit the scene. This produces very accurate results but can be slow and noisy. The light cache engine calculates GI by tracing rays from each light source and sorting them in a cache that can be reused for different pixels. This produces very fast results but can be less accurate and introduce artifacts. So combining them both in primary and secondary render engine will give us a perfect render. So the light cache engine has two main parameters that control the quality and speed of the rendering, subdivs and sample size. The subdivs parameter sets the number of rays traced from each light sources. The higher the value, the better the quality, but also the longer the render time. The sample size parameter sets the size of each ray in world units. The lower this value, the better the quality, but also the longer the render time. For this tutorial, we'll use subdivs value of 1000 and sample size value of 0.02. As you can see, the default sample size value is 0.01, we will use 0.02. These values are a good compromise between quality and speed for most scenes. You can experiment with different values to find the best balance for your scene. Now let's go to image sequence. Triangulation is one of the options for the sequence type parameter in the system rollout of V-Ray for 3ds Max. It determines the order in which the regions or buckets are rendered. A bucket is a rectangular part of the currently rendered frame that is rendered independently from other buckets. Triangulation is the default and usually the best choice, especially if you use a lot of dynamic geometry, displacement mapped objects, V-Ray proxy or V-Ray far objects. This option walks through the image in a consistent manner. It displays information as it is calculated using the most efficient sequence for the current rendering settings and uses geometry that was generated for previous buckets to render subsequent buckets. Triangulation can also reduce the problem of hanging buckets, those little parts of an image that take a long time to finish rendering or don't finish rendering at all. This is all because triangulation keeps the buckets close together and avoids rendering parts of the image that are far away from each other. You can change the sequence type parameter to other options such as top to bottom, left to right, checker, spiral or Hilbert curve depending on your scene complexity and render settings. However, triangulation is usually the most optimal choice for most cases. Now let's talk about render elements. Render elements are a way to break out renders into their component parts such as diffuse color, reflections, shadows, matters, etc. This gives fine control over the final image when using compositing or image editing applications like Photoshop when reassembling the final image from its component elements. The choice of render elements depends on your scene complexity, render settings and compositing needs. Some of the common render elements that are useful for post-productions are Alpha. Alpha separates the background environment or sky from foreground. Lighting. Lighting contains all direct diffuse illumination in the scene from both V-Ray lights and GI. V-Ray denoiser. If you have less time for rendering, you can use higher noise threshold for a very fast render and use V-Ray denoiser render element to denoise the image and get a good result. Global illumination. Global illumination contains all indirect diffuse illumination in the scene. Reflection contains all indirect reflections in the scene. Refraction contains all the refraction in the scene. Specular contains all the direct reflections of lights in the scene. Material ID or object ID assigns a solid color to each material or object in the scene based on its ID number. Z-depth stores the distance from the camera to each point in the scene as a grayscale value. You can use this to create a field of depth in Photoshop. Velocity. Velocity stores the velocity of moving object as RGB colors. So these are some render elements that you can use for post-production. So this was our video for today. You can use these render settings, and if you get good results, please let me know in the comments, or if you find any difficulties or any obstacles, also let me know in the comments. Thank you very much for watching this video. I will see you guys in the next video. Stay safe, stay healthy. Bye.